If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free, and I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you.
To Mace. I met Johnny Mason in January 1979. When I was assigned to the Sierra Army Depot in Herlong, California. This was my first duty assignment. I was assigned to the 4th Platoon, where Mace, that's what we called him when we were out of uniform, was our platoon sergeant. When I first met Mace, I thought I was back in basic training. He quickly laid the laws down, and I knew I had to be a model soldier, because I did not want to make him mad at me. I quickly realized that Mace was a godsend. He was more like a father to me than my best friend Wesley Cook, who I grew up with and was also my roommate in the barracks in Herlong. Mace would put fear in you, but had a huge heart. He would do anything for you, but when you screwed up, he would let you know, and that is one of the reasons I respected him so much. Although I never saw him again after leaving Herlong, I did speak to him several times on the phone in 2019, where we had some long and great conversations. After all those years, Mace was still Mace, and that's what I loved about him. I can honestly say that he played a major role in me becoming the man and soldier that I came to be, and as I told him on the phone, I would never forget that. I had told him that I was going to make the trip out west to see him one day, but that day never came, and I'll probably regret that for the rest of my life. So I'd like to send my condolences to Gene and the family. Mace was a great man, and our paths will cross again one day. Love you, Mace. And rest in peace. Larry Q. McDowell, aka Mac.
To Mace. Hello all. My name is Wesley Cook. Back in my army days, I was known as Cookie. I first met Sergeant Mason in late December 1978 when I arrived at Herlong, California, and was stationed at the 980th Military Police Company. Upon my arrival, I was placed into the 2nd Platoon, which I did not like at all. I shared these feelings with my best friend, who I grew up with, Larry McDowell, Mac, and he told me that he would talk to his platoon sergeant about trying to move me over to the 4th Platoon where he was. Now, I really didn't think that that was going to be good for me either, because that was Sergeant Johnny Mason's platoon, and Sergeant Mason was the meanest man within 200 miles of Herlong, California. Unknown to me, when I was transferred to the 4th Platoon around February 1979, that would be the beginning of a lifelong friendship and admiration for Sergeant Mason. I found out, after serving very little time under his leadership, that he was not mean at all. Sergeant Mason did not have one mean bone in his body. His spine and his mouth, however, was as hard as iron, while his heart was made of gold. That was necessary in order to perform his job, and he did his job extremely well. He helped me and thousands of men and women become soldiers, and helped us to become men and women who are making a difference in this world today. I have had many failures in my 60 years of life so far, and I have been blessed to have a measure of success. Sergeant Mason's leadership has played a major role in overcoming my failures and achieving my successes. This is how I will close this letter. A lion can be a lamb, but no matter how hard a lamb tries, he cannot be a lion. Make no mistake, Johnny Mason was a lion, but I loved his lamb side more. I love you, Mace. I love you, man. Thank you for everything. Rest in peace. W.B. Cook, Cookie.
Thank you.
First United States, the United States Army, and a grateful nation. Please accept this flag as a symbol of appreciation for your loved ones' honorable and faithful service.
Service, and I think Johnny would be proud, and I will see you soon.